Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all Dinarans on the go and in the know, wherever you may be. It is November 2, 2019. No matter what, know that today, we are one day closer to our goal than yesterday. First article of interest: Baghdad building now a landmark in anti-government protests. By Kasim Abdul Zara, Associated Press, November 2, 2019-6:13 a.m. Baghdad AP. The protesters stand by the thousands on the abandoned building's open floors, waving Iraqi flags and cheering. Some sit on the edge, feet dangling in the air from high floors as they sway to blasting music. They have a bird's-eye view of Baghdad and the tens of thousands of demonstrators below. At night, they wave the lights on their mobile phones at comrades on the ground. Then they move inside the building, dine together, play dominoes and sing patriotic songs until the early hours of the morning. They also are able to watch the security forces battling the protesters. The 14-story, Saddam Hussein era on the Tigris River has emerged as a landmark in the anti-government protests gripping Iraq. The structure has been abandoned since 2003, when it was bombed by the US-led forces in their invasion, but has now been taken over from security forces by demonstrators since October 25th. They have sworn not to leave it. Next article of interest: Iraqi government should listen to legitimate demands of protesters. Pompeo, 2 Nov. 2019-6:17/updated 5 hours ago. U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo backed massive anti-government protests in Iraq, which have been raging for a month despite the curfew, violence, and high death toll. The government of Iraq should listen to the legitimate demands made by the Iraqi people who have taken to the streets to have their voices heard, Pompeo tweeted on Friday. The U.S. supports the Iraqi people who require a genuine exercise in accountability and justice. The government of Iraq should listen to the legitimate demands made by the Iraqi people who have taken to the streets to have their voices heard. The U.S. supports the Iraqi people who require a genuine exercise in accountability and justice. Secretary Pompeo at Sec Pompeo. The large-scale protests, which began a month ago, continue to rage across Iraq despite a curfew imposed in Baghdad. The demonstrators flooded the streets, expressing anger over corruption, unemployment, and poor public services. They demand the resignation of Prime Minister Adil Abdul Mahdi and a complete overhaul of the political system, set up after the 2003 U.S. invasion of Iraq. At least 250 protesters have died in clashes with Iraqi security forces, some allegedly killed by sniper fire. Responding to the rallies, President Barham Saleh said the Prime Minister is ready to step down as soon as his replacement is found. He also promised to hold snap elections and to change the electoral law, allowing people under the currently mandated age of 35 to run for parliament. Next article of interest: protesters in Iraq rebuke Iran with chants of "Get out, Iran, free Baghdad." Mirad Makhmudov and Lee J. Walker, Modern Tokyo Times. The crisis in Iraq is not abating because protesters demand genuine political change. At the same time, protesters want Iran to keep out of the body politic of Iraq. Equally important, protests have erupted in Shia heartlands. Hence, for many protesters, Iran is a hostile nation that is infringing on the sovereignty of Iraq. Unbelievably, the death toll is now over 250. This applies to open killings by the Iraqi security apparatus and militias that are loyal to Iran. Thus, the situation is extremely critical. France 24 reports, videos have been circulating of protesters hitting their shoes against a poster of Iran's supreme leader Ayatollah Khomeini and the head of the Iranian Revolutionary Guard elite Quds force, the infamous Qasem Soleimani, in what appears to be Baghdad Tahrir Square. In Iraq, the Shia protesters are chanting, "Get out, Iran, free Baghdad." The people of Iraq are disillusioned by endless corruption, the sense of hopelessness, the wastage of energy resources, cronyism, the political elites being answerable to foreign powers, a deplorable infrastructure, poverty, high unemployment, and other issues. Thus, vast numbers of Iraqis can take any more despite the knowledge that death may await them. This is based on security forces and militias loyal to Iran killing protesters in horrendous circumstances. The BBC utters, Iraqi Prime Minister Adil Abdul Mahdi will resign if political parties can agree on his replacement, the president has says, as mass protests continue. It remains to be seen how developments will unfold because Iran will still seek to hold the strings in Iraq. Similarly, With the power concentration mechanisms being weak in Iraq, then events are unpredictable. Hence, it appears that the blood will keep flowing in Iraq, while more Iraqis will be seen trampling on the painted flag of Iran. Next article of interest, Masood Barzani. The current situation in Iraq is the result of the failure of 15 years. Cords of Brazil November 2, 2019 6-29-12. Kurdistan Democratic Party KDP leader Masood Barzani on Saturday issued a statement on the current protests in Iraq and calls for amendments to the constitution. We are concerned about the current political situation in Iraq and the protests and demonstrations of citizens, Barzani said in a statement. Citizens have many concerns and problems, and they have the right to demonstrate, protest and express their demands. It is therefore necessary to listen to the demands of the people and not to solve problems through violence and bloodshed. Abazaid and Barzani, saying that one of the most important problems facing Iraq is the non-application of the constitution, adding, if the Iraqi constitution was implemented in full, we would not have faced most of the previous and current problems. He pointed out that the cause of the current situation is the Iraqi election law. In order to solve the problem from the basis, must change this law so that the election results reflect the real and fair demands of all components. Regarding calls for changing the Iraqi constitution, Barzani said, we believe that changing the constitution is not by force or by force. In any case, changing the constitution should not undermine the democratic system, as well as diminish the rights of the Kurdish people and other components. We emphasize that it is the democratic system that is in the interest of the Iraqi people, not the dictatorship, Barzani concluded. Next article of interest. This is the date of interrogation of Adel Abdulmahdi in Parliament, Baghdad, November 2, 2019. The deputy of the coalition of Sayyaran Raad Hussein, on Saturday, the date of questioning Prime Minister Adel Abdulmahdi in the House of Representatives on demonstrations and the government program, Hussein said in a press statement that the members of the alliance and the victory gathered the signatures of more than 60 deputies to interrogate Abdulmahdi on the demands of the demonstrators and review what has been achieved from the government program, pointing out that the presidency of the parliament sent a notification to Abdulmahdi to attend within the House of Representatives. He added that the response to the request of the parliament is within 7 days, but Abdulmahdi will attend the parliament midweek as the country is going through critical conditions and large popular protests, noting that the presence of Abdulmahdi in the parliament is important to know the facts. Next article of interest. Iraqi parliament speaker assures protesters of speedy reforms. Saturday, November 2, 2019 12:28 p.m. protests continue in Iraq. The Iraqi Parliament Speaker Mohammed Al-Albasi said Saturday that the parliament will work intensively and continuously for the popular demands of the anti-government protests. The parliament will be on continuous open session and will work day and night in order to speed up the implementation of the reforms demanded by the people in accordance with the roadmap of the Marja religious Shiite leadership, according to a statement issued by Al-Albasi. We will work hard to make all constitutional amendments in partnership with representatives of demonstrators, dignitaries, experts and academics, Al-Albasi said. Al-Albasi's statement came a day after the Shiite cleric Ayatollah Ali al-Sistani, who heads the Shiite religious leadership in Iraq, called on the Iraqi authorities not to push combat forces in dealing with sit-ins and peaceful demonstrations. Al-Sistani expressed his rejection to any internal or external interference in the affairs of Iraq, saying that the necessary reform must be done in accordance with the people's choice, according to Al-Sistani's statement. Demonstrations are still ongoing in Baghdad and other cities in central and southern Iraq for the 9th successive day over comprehensive reform, corruption, improvement of public services and job opportunities. Earlier last month, massive protests erupted in the Iraqi capital of Baghdad and other central and southern provinces for similar reasons, Xinhua reported. Next article of interest. Masood Barzani calls for implementation of Iraqi constitution as nationwide protests continue. November 2, 2019 ERBIL Kurdistan 24 Kurdistan Democratic Party KDP. President Masood Barzani on Saturday said the issues in Iraq, which have led to nationwide protests, are a result of years of poor governance and ignoring of the Iraqi constitution. In a statement published on his official website, Barzani expressed his concerns about the political tension and protests taking place in Iraq, adding that the unrest is a result of 15 years of failure by the federal government, The Iraqi people have witnessed a great deal of suffering, and they have the right to demand their rights, he said. The problems can only be solved by listening to the legitimate demands of the people and not through bloodshed. One of Iraq's biggest problems is not implementing the constitution, Barzani emphasized, highlighting that if the constitution were effectively executed, the previous and current problems would not exist. Barzani mentioned that another factor for the issues in Iraq is the election law. The election law must be amended in a way that results from the true and just reflection of the factions, the statement read. Regarding calls for an amendment to the Iraqi constitution, the senior Kurdish leader said no such move could be made by force. An amendment of the Iraqi constitution must not affect the principles of democracy and the rights of the Kurds or any other groups, he said. Barzani affirmed that a democratic system is in the best interest of the people of Iraq, concluding that any form of dictatorship or amendment to the constitution must be done through legal and constitutional mechanisms. Next article of interest, Prime Minister's spokesman, Abdul Mahdi will submit the ministerial change to parliament for a vote, 2 November, 2019 Baghdad. Prime Minister spokesman William Warda confirmed on Saturday that the Prime Minister intends to submit the ministerial changes in the coming days, indicating that the expansion depends on the performance of the ministers during the recent period and the implementation of reforms. Warda told Al Maluma that Prime Minister Del Abdul Mahdi is about to complete the partial cabinet change in the Bennett ND submit his list to the House of Representatives for a vote. He added that the Prime Minister intends to expand the ministerial change to the rest of the other positions in the government, noting that the change in assessment is taking place over the implementation of the ministerial program of ministers and the implementation of reforms. He explained that the latter will submit a list of ministerial change during the coming period of the parliament. Next article of interest, the Council of Ministers is making new appointments to independent bodies. November 1, 2019-2013 Baghdad. The Council of Ministers, the appointment of 9 personalities in senior positions in independent bodies. The appointments were distributed as undersecretary in the Hajj and Umrah Commission, the Secretariat of Baghdad, the Integrity Commission, the Shiite Endowment Bureau, the Endowment Bureau of Other Religions, the Accountability and Justice Commission, the Central Bank of Iraq, the Investment Commission and the Prisoners Foundation. Next article of interest, Parliamentary Foreign Relations. The demonstrators sent a message to Iran that they should be aware of. 2 November, 2019 Baghdad, Deputy Chairman of the Committee on Foreign Relations Zafer Alani, on Saturday, that the slogans of the demonstrators confirmed the rejection of the Iranian guardianship approach. The voices of the demonstrators against Iranian interference in the Iraqi affairs came in a sincere expression of the Iraqi rejection of the guardianship approach and the policy of dictates by Tehran towards Iraq. Ani said in a statement received by Shafak News, "We have pointed out from an early stage that the arrogance policy of the rulers of Iran will lead our country to terror and the people lose their confidence in a regime that wants to control its abilities by external hands seeking to harness the fate of our country as part of its external conflicts," he said. Aggressive approach, the statements of Iranian officials, starting with their leader, who accused the opponents of various false accusations, represent a gross and provocative intervention and a grave injury to the dignity of every Iraqi who cherishes his country and seeks independence and stability, he said. Iranian decision-makers should be aware of this message and act in line with the desire of the two neighboring countries for a close relationship based on mutual respect and common interests. More articles of interest to come. Don't forget to hit that like subscribe button and check out the CEP Currency Exchange Planner. The link is in the description panel. Make sure to tell them the Dinarian sent you so you get the extra pre-arranged discount. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarian.